is going?
Very
it's good. It's meeting your expectations. Okay, so please understand, this is not a technique. Okay, this is one step of a path. Okay, what I am giving you is not a simple one technique. There are many techniques available. This is not a technique. This is not just a technique. It's a path. As you evolve, this keeps on refining to lead to higher and higher consciousness. Emotional disturbances, mental clarity, all those things will emerge as you move along the path. This is the first step of a path. Okay? This step itself, you are comfortable, it's fine for you. If you want to go to the next step, you can go. Like that, it's there. There are 9 steps. Okay? So, take this step and see whether it works for you. And if you feel you are comfortable, you feel you want to go to the next level, next step, you can come continue. You can join together. And there is a sufficiently large group, I'll conduct the next level, next session. So this is, I'm not giving you a technique, a piecemeal technique to do something and go. I'm giving you a path. Okay? This path has Vedantic teaching, this path has yogic teaching, and this path has traditional tantra teaching. Together it's an integrated path. Okay? Depending on how much you want to take, how much you want to grow, it will go. But the growth will happen in a group, not individually. Okay, those who want to receive further communication, you can contact Gayatri, you can give a phone number, contact number. All most of the communication goes on WhatsApp message. So daily there is some WhatsApp messages which will come. I have talked on many topics. Lot of audio, video recordings are there. Most of your questions are answered in those recordings. You can post your questions. You can get back some of my students. Umaji is there. She will find out which class has answered that, and she will need to reply back. If there's a new question, I'll answer. But daily there will be communication, some connection. If you feel like keeping in touch, you can give your name, phone number, and communication. Most of the communication goes on WhatsApp. That's most convenient method today. So let us go to Makara. You understood the importance of Makara. Now let us go to, what is the step number we have covered?
6. 7. 7th step.
Now this is 8th step. Or 7th step.
8th step.
Step number 8 is Akara, Ukara, Makara in a single breath. Not Om. Like that. Okay, like that. It is a single breath. So you have to take a deep breath. When you say a, vibration will start here. Oom, vibration will move here. Vibration will move here. But now, you need to keep your eyes in this posture. Above horizon, to a distant point, far off point in the sky. As if you are watching a very distant star. Okay. First keep your eyes in that posture and just try it out. What happened? Through third eye, you look at a distant place. Neck should be slightly bent backwards. Slightly. Okay, so over your eyes, can anybody tell me what do you experience when you do that?
Sensations here, light also.
Yeah, you can feel small sensation here and light. Anybody else?
Vastness.
You feel vastness. Okay, then?
Instant stillness.
Mind becomes still. Okay. See, if you look at many of these saints' photographs, okay, not traditionally, typically Western saints, okay, not Indian saints. Indian saints, you see most of them with closed eyes. With closed eyes, they are going internally. If you look at the Western saints, the eyes will be like this, watching a distant place. Actually, this is the center. The Adna Chakra has dual role. Go inwards to the self or go outwards to the cosmos. Inner to the self is self-realization, Cosmos is God communication, God communion. What we call as God, okay? For God is the entire cosmos. God is one which has always become the entire cosmos. When you look at it like this, you feel that communion. Just see, simple eyes deposition. Just close your eyes and you start feeling deep stillness. And a small pull at that Ajna chakra. You may have to bend your neck slightly backwards like this. Not too back until you start feeling a pull there. Should do it with closed eyes, not open eyes. I should be closed. Open your eyes. Okay. Now, how many people felt a pull at the center? You can feel that, right? That pull at the center. And how many people felt the mind become suddenly calm?
Calmness
happens. Actually, this is the center for prayer. This is the center for prayer. God communication happens through this center. That's why we put the kumkuma. Okay. Whereas the meditation center is up above, but before that, communion with the God. Now, how many of you do puja every day? Okay. So, in puja, what do you do? What are the steps involved in puja?
What is it?
Steps.
Jyoti. What is involved in what?
Steps. Puja. What are the steps in puja? Steps.
Lighting.
What do you do in puja?
Lighting.
Okay. Yeah.
I don't do anything. Lighting.
Haldi kumkum. Flowers. Begin with cleaning the and
cleaning.
Mantra.
Udbatti.
Then meditation. Then pray.
Yeah. Offering.
Pray. Offering. Okay.
Prices.
So, how many of you understand this concept called Manasa Puja? What is Manasa Puja?
Imagine what you are doing, actually in terms of a ritual, but you are doing it from within yourself.
So you do within yourself. Okay. So this is one step beyond physical puja, manasa puja. This is the next step. This is physical puja, manasa puja is over. That's what you have done. This is the next puja, next level, what you have done, what you are doing. When puja, how many of you offer flowers? Water, milk. For puja to the God, you offer water, milk and flower. Where did the flower come from? Plant. Milk come from? Water. What did you offer from yourself?
Whatever
is his,
we are giving it back to
him. Whatever he is, you have to give back. Not his.
That is our mind.
Whatever you think you are, that is what you have to offer to the God. Not even whatever his.
Yeah.
Somebody was very romantic. Okay? For a honeymoon, they went to all over the world and then went to Taj Mahal. Symbol of love. Oh dear, I love you so much, I offer Taj Mahal to you. Taj Mahal is not belong, doesn't belong to this fellow. You are offering. We are good at offering what doesn't belong to us. Okay, what is to be offered to God is your body, mind and intellect. That only belongs to you. Rest, taking something from nature and offering is Bahya Puja. offering to something God in Manasi Puja, still you have an identical body and mind. Okay? Offering to the God what you call you are is called real puja. Chapter 18, Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam raja aham sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami maashuchaha. Sarva dharman parityajya, that means this Bhagavad Gita, okay, Bhagavan Krishna says sarva dharman parityajya, we think that dharma means religion, it has nothing to do with religion. Dharma means nature, our nature. Okay, nature of fire is burning, dharma of fire is burning, dharma of water is cooling. What is your nature? What is your nature depends on what you think you are. Body, mind, intellect. Okay? When you take a, I am a woman, body, dharma of woman. Mind. When I say dharma is when you interact with the external. So, body, mind and intellect is what makes our nature. Dharma. That offering is the next step. Step number?
Nine.
Step number nine. That if you offer body, mind and intellect to the universal, that's the puja. Okay? So now when you offer that, what is left for you? Nothing. Body, mind and intellect belongs to the prakriti. Okay, it doesn't belong to you. It's a part of the nature. Body is a part of the earth element of nature. Blood is a part of water element of nature. Bone is a part of earth element in nature. Air is a part of nature. Space is a part of nature. What does belong to you? What belongs to you is the consciousness, I, the self. Okay? When you offer what belongs to nature, to the God, when I say God, universal energy, Shakti, then the consciousness part is ready for next level of meditation. Okay? So how do you offer that? Is anything in nature exists in three states. Anything in nature exists in three states. Solid, liquid, vapor. Solid, liquid, vapor. Understand? Body is solid. Mind is liquid flowing. Okay? Consciousness is vapor. All over. The body is solidified. Liquid, the mind is flowing and consciousness is all over. These are the three states. So, when we are body, we feel limited. When we are the mind, we keep on flowing. Okay? So, when we move to the next level, it becomes energy. Body, mind is nothing but energy. The energetic connection through the universe happens through this center. Are you clear? So then what happens? The mind becomes still because the mind is disturbed. So many people say mind is disturbed because you think the mind belongs to you. Mind is a part of the prakriti, nature. That is the purpose of giving flower and water and milk. They are symbolic in nature. The milk you are giving, saying that this is mine, purified mind I am offering, but we offer only milk, but actually we have to offer mind. The flower we are offering saying that this is the flower of my heart. They are actually not physical objects, they are psychological objects we are symbolically offering to God. Now, let us do an energetic offering in the form of energy with connect to the universe through the third eye. Okay? So you chant akara, ukara, makara in a single breath. Let that makara radiate. Your eyes should be in that posture and let that makara radiate deep into the universe. Visualize that makara wave spreading deep into the universe. Energy waves can spread anywhere. So just through makara, connect to the universe. Universe, and then I say universe is manifest, prakriti, the nature. Keep your hands in the meditative posture. What is this step number?
Nine.
Let us chant together. Akara, deep breath. Akara, ukara, makara. Eyes in that posture. Let that sound, energy and vibration travel far into the universe. So the energy of the body at the navel center, energy of the heart, energy of the intellect. These three we are surrendering to the divine. Calmness. Sit with a deep understanding. The body, mind, energy belongs to the Universal Mother. Slowly open your eyes. Okay. Can anybody tell what happened?
What are the timings for the
eye? This, depending on your capability. It's up to you. You don't have to depend on anybody. Okay, there's no proportion. How comfortable you feel? Okay? This is your comfortable.
Not necessarily that we should concentrate on
one. No. This is comfort. You will fine tune it yourself. There's nothing, no proportion. Okay? Can anybody explain what you feel? What happens?
Very calm.
Very calm. Anybody else?
Vibrations. Began
pure
and then moved upwards and
yeah.
Then moved
upwards
and...
Right. So what happens to
your
mind?
Mind was calm.
Calm. Okay?
No thoughts.
Anybody has heard this concept called Naivedya? Right? What is Naivedya?
Offering to God.
Naivedya is offering to God. Right? What do? Laddu, jalebi, many things. And offer to God and we eat. Right? So, naivedya means, please understand, nahi vedya. This doesn't belong to me. Okay? Vedya means understand. To understand that you are offering to God, that what you doesn't belong to God. That what God is given is called prasadam. Okay? That we eat. You understand? Naivedya means nahi, nahi means no. Vedya means understand. With the understanding you are offering to God. So we are offering to God. This laddu I only made. Very nice. Okay. We are offering to God nahi, nahi vedya. That means it doesn't belong to me. I am actually instrument in your service. You are offering to the God and taking back prasadam. You understood? Just now what you did is body, mind and intellect, you did a naivedyam, nihivedya. You are offering to universal mother. And you got the prasadam. Prasada means, sada means calmness of the mind. Okay? The moment you do that, you get a calmness of the mind. That's called prasada. Real meaning of prasada means calmness of the mind. Prasada, literal meaning is calmness. Sanskrit is not a Sanskrit, I mean the words which our ancestors used had a very precise meaning. Naivedya means you offer to God something you think it belongs to you. Okay? That's what mind you start building. Okay? Just understand that, okay, it doesn't belong to me. God, it belongs to you. I am taking prasadam from you. Now what we don't do is what we think it belongs to us, but really it doesn't belong to us, is three: body, mind and intellect. That we never offer. Okay? So that body, mind and intellect we offer to God, the divine, universal mother, in the form of energy, and say, this belongs to you. And immediately there's a deep calmness happens. So the body center is navel center, mind center is anahata, heart center, intellectual center is apna chakra. These three you are offering as energy to the universal mother. And definitely you know that naivedyam will offer to God and making sure that God will give back. Otherwise, next time you'll think twice before me. Okay? So, laddu and all, you keep it in front of Ganesha. Disappears, couple of laddus disappear. Then you make sure how many laddus you have to keep on that. So, when you say body, mind and intellect is offered, it will come back to you. But it will come back in the prasada. Means calmness of the mind which you feel immediately. Please understand. Okay? Otherwise, people will, if I go for body, mind and intellect, what will happen to me? Immediately, there is a deep calmness. You feel, that is called prasada. Okay, this is actually anything we do, there's a different level of meaning. Okay, a physical, a psychological, and spiritual. This is the third level. This is called adi bhautika, adi daivika, adhyatmika. We can do a physical level puja, we can do adi daivika puja, manasika puja, and adhyatmika. This is at the spiritual level. We are going into deeper in our puja practice. We are offering body, mind, and intellect belongs to you. And that comes back with the purification of deep silence and peace. Are we clear? Anybody has a question? Are we clear? So let us repeat it again. Step number 9, right? Just for recollection, what's step number 1? Shitilikarna. Step number 2? Shaktisanchalana. Step number 3? Guruvandana. Sankalpa. Step number 4? Asana and mudra. Mudra is, I am not the body, mind, intellect. Okay. Step number 5? Akara. Step number 6? Step number 7? Step number 8? Akara, ukara, makara. Then step number 8 again.
Silence.
Yeah. Let us repeat step number 8. Akara, ukara, makara together. prasadam. Prasadam means a mind which is deeply silent. See that silence, calmness spreading throughout the body, mind, complex. So, can all of you, could all of you experience that deep silence and peace?
Yes.
Okay. This is the real meaning of prasadam. This is actually real naivedyam. Naivedyam is, it doesn't belong to me. The body, mind and intellect belongs to prakriti, nature, shakti. Let us go to next step. Step number?
9.
Okay. 9 or 10? 9. Okay. Step number 9 is Omkara. Omkara is the sound, cosmic sound, connects the individual to the universal. A Jivatma to Paramatma. So when you are not a body, mind and intellect, body, mind and intellect belongs to prakriti, nature. The atma belongs to paramatma. So look at your life. The body came to you from your father and mother. One cell of your body, one cell of the father and one cell of the mother together created your body. Biological father and biological mother gave one cell, donated one cell to creation, in your, for you. But then one cell became two cell became four cell became eight cell became 16 cells. It increased and it became a ball of meat. You understand? There are cells, two cells, just what parents contributed is just one cell. Father gave one cell, mother gave one cell. But then one cell became two, two cell became four cell became eight cell became 16, 32, and it became a ball of meat in a couple of months. The ball of meat suddenly started developing eyes at some cells, suddenly started developing ears at some cells, mouth at some cells, different organ exactly at same place, right place. It didn't happen that eyes came here, ears came here, no. At the precise location it came. So, this intelligence which is required, you say it's genetic intelligence is memory. The activation of genetic intelligence happened through universal energy shakti. So the father and mother contribute one cell each, but rest of your life was taken care by the universal mother shakti. Including the feeding through the umbilical cord. That universal intelligence took care of our life right from the two cells. So what is the contribution of father and mother? Two cells in your whole body. The replication of that and growing of that is the universal energy. The biological parents in a way contributed to your physical body. Okay? The body initiated by biological parents but nurtured by the universal energy. The intelligence of the universal energy. Exactly, it knows precisely. Eyes here, ears here, mouth here, where the cell, mass of cell has to grow. That requires tremendous amount of intelligence. Okay? Where did the mind come from? The body came from the biological parents, not fully. Out of billion cells, two cells. Okay? Where did the mind come from? You tell me in your mind what is not there given by society. The environment.
Can you define mind?
What is mind? Mind is nothing but thought process. Huh? Mind is nothing but thought process. And there are different levels, right? When I say mind, thoughts, what becomes? Mind is a bundle of thoughts.
Mind is?
Bundle of thoughts.
Bundle of thoughts.
Bundle of thoughts. Right? The mind is actually everything what we see and experience.
So but this, side by side, it's very difficult to define mind. No one has defined it so.
No, actually, Ramana Maharshi, Ramana Maharshi defines the mind. Mind is nothing but bundle of thoughts. We need to start somewhere. We understand. Otherwise, everything we keep vague. So when I say mind is a bundle of thoughts, okay. Actually, I met a scientist in New York. I met a big neurologist. I asked him, "What is the relationship between brain and mind?" He says, "We have not understood so far. We believe that mind is because of brain." Okay. Whereas all from thousands of years we say mind is uses the brain in India. So there is different understanding. I'm coming from the traditional understanding of this spiritual understanding, right? If you go to modern psychiatry, actually modern psychiatry and modern science, many of them, they have an inverted view of the world. They take the matter first and then see consciousness. That's why we said there are three views of the world. Material view, then dualistic view and consciousness view. So many of our enlightened beings, they have come from the consciousness view, the other way. Okay? Many of the material science, they start from this way and their view of the world is inverted. Whereas this view is from top down, bottom up and middle. There are three views. So whenever I teach, whenever I speak from the view of the traditional Indian spiritual tradition. I may translate and put it in your words, you can understand. But otherwise, it is coming from the enlightened view, which comes from a tradition. So when I say mind, it is nothing but bundle of thoughts. Mind is everything, okay? But right now I take this mind. Now you tell me in your thoughts, tell me a thought which is not coming from the society. Any thought you have is a contribution from society. From friends said something, TV said something, politician said something, okay? But then you say, I think like that. Your stamp is I. The dress you chose, everything, what our thinking pattern comes from the environment. So the body comes from the parent, the mind comes from the society. Where did the consciousness come from?
Divine.
Consciousness, it came from divine, that's Atma. So that doesn't come from anywhere.
Universal.
That's universal God. So the body and mind, in a sense, belong to the nature, Prakriti. The consciousness belongs to the Paramatma. So you are actually a Shakti or Prakriti, consciousness, Chaitanya. A combination of these two is Jivatma, what you are. Okay. So now we'll go to the next level of meditation. What happens when you are born, when the child is born? This region of the brain, what happens to that?
Very soft.
Very soft. Soft will be there. Softness will be there. That softness in a couple of months becomes hard. Very soft. Actually, we say the child is divine. Okay. When the child is born, it has two connections. Energy connection to the mother through umbilical cord, which is Prakriti. The Chaitanya consciousness connection through the Sahasrara, top of the head. When the umbilical cord is cut, you feel disconnected from the mother nature. When the sahasrara becomes hardened, you disconnect, feel disconnect from the Paramatma. In reality, it's not happened, but at our consciousness level, or a deeper level, there's a disconnection from the consciousness at this level and mother in this level. So all our prayer has been Shiva, Shakti, Narayana, Lakshmi, the Paramatma and counterpart Shakti for re-establishing this connection. That's all. In the prayer you may ask for money, wealth, house, children and all those things. But really deepest urges to re-establish the
connection.
The connections are two. One is with Shakti and one is with the Chaitanya, consciousness. The Chaitanya feels separated at this level. The Shakti gets separated at the umbilical cord. And because of these two separations, you start living here, in between, Trishanko. Neither here nor there. That's Jivatma. Okay? So now, let us offer our energy, let us connect with the energy through the Sahasrara. The step number?
9.
When you chant Omkara, now don't split into Akara, Omkara, Makara. It is a single Omkara. When you chant, okay, now eyes should be again in this posture, okay, and eyes try to move towards the Makara to upward as much as you can, but don't stretch too much. In sense, follow the energy pattern at the top of the head.
Yeah. How much up can you?
No, a little bit. It's not very space. It's only awareness has to move. So you become aware, right? Just a little bit. So I would say that energy, we can become aware of energy up to this point. That's what is actually Shiva's jata. Okay, the Shiva's jata is actually a spiritual practice. At this, the energy we can sense up to this point. Beyond that, we can't sense the energy. Beyond that, energy becomes a part of universal energy. So, become aware of the energy up to this point. Okay, little bit follow with your eyes. Don't stretch too much. Just become aware with the Omkara sound. Okay. The neck has to be slightly bent backwards. When you chant Omkara, let that vibration move through the top of your head, crown of your head. The sound vibration energy move upwards. Let it spread throughout the universe. By this process, you are connecting with the entire universe, Shakti, and mind moves to the top of the head, Sahasrara. That's where the place union of Jivatma and Paramatma happens momentarily. Let us chant Omkara, becoming aware of the movement of the Makara to the top of the head, deep into the space and universe. Experience the energy at the top of the head, slight pull at the crown, that's the top of the head. Mind has felt the calmness and peace. Again, Omkara. Oh.
Stay in that blissful state. So can anybody explain what happened?
No
thoughts at all. What happens? Mind becomes still.
Silence.
Connected. This momentary experience called samadhi. You are staying in pure awareness. Mind is nothing but a bundle of thoughts. Mind becomes but silent and merges with the universal consciousness. Then that is stillness and bliss and awareness. It is not unconscious. Okay, that union is called samadhi. So what you experienced, if you have done that, a momentary samadhi. How many people didn't experience this? Can you please raise your hands? 2, 3, 4, 5. Other people experienced? So can you explain what happened, what you didn't experience?
For that very brief second, it's absolute stillness.
Yeah.
When there is no thought.
Correct. That no thought state, it's a split second only, because right now we are still in step number 1 of 9 steps. Okay? But I am giving you a glimpse of that. Okay? So that stillness, what you experience, is called consciousness, chaitanya. That is the nature of Paramatma. Anybody else? What was that? Somebody else raised their hand? Yeah. What about somebody else raised their hand?
Body in a state.
Huh?
A state where I feel there is nobody for me.
There's nobody. There's no body, but you are there.
A consciousness.
Chaitanya is there. Body is not you. The body belongs to Prakriti. That already you have done that. So this is the state of Chaitanya, pure awareness. Okay? Did everybody understood what I am saying? If there are any questions, please ask. Then we will go to that. Again, repeat this step so that you can understand again. Experience this again. That momentary silence, stillness. There's no body, there's nothing, but you are there. Stillness, that you and the universal consciousness, they are not separate. That's why it's pure stillness. So what will happen in this process of practicing of samadhi, I tell you. The mind by nature goes towards the world. That's what mind is a product of the world. Mind is a product of
the world.
When I say mind, thoughts are product of the society. I can guarantee you there's no single thought in your mind which is not come from society. Thoughts are nothing but churning out what is there. Then you say, I, my thought, I believe so. You never believe anything. Okay, whatever belief is put into your head by some society. If you say this came from society, what really belongs to you is consciousness, Chaitanya. You never experience Chaitanya because you are so dragged by the environment. Now, for a brief moment, you are experiencing that. Okay? So, what happened is, there are three things. When you say you, this Jivatma. The consciousness means the Paramatma, that. And what took you there is Shakti, energy. Okay? Please understand, each of the steps 1 to 12, what I have said, they are precise in nature. They are not techniques. These are precise steps. Okay? It's very, very well defined, very clear steps. Each of these steps are designed such a way that it will purify your consciousness and you can experience that samadhi momentarily, and gradually you can experience all the time, depending on how much you make progress. These are not techniques, okay? There are so many techniques are available. This is not a technique, this is a path. There are 9 steps path. This is the first step of 9 steps where you are able to experience the samadhi momentarily. Okay? So now, do you understand when I say consciousness, you understood? The consciousness is when any or objects are removed, then what remains is consciousness. The consciousness remains irrespective of anything. That's the Paramatma. Not blankness, awareness. It's not blankness. Blankness means unconscious. It's not unconscious, it's awareness. Okay, blankness is stone. The stone is not stone. It's a pure awareness, silence and bliss. Okay. That is your nature also. And that is called light. That is the supreme light, Param Jyoti. Your nature is of that light. That's why you are Atma Jyoti. Okay? Are clear? So we'll repeat that and experience this again. Step number what?
9. 10.
Step number 10, we'll repeat. Okay? Let us do it. Let's do a couple of more omkaras. Let us say we'll do 18 omkaras this time. Just to experience a deeper connection. You can do it as much you can, okay? 3 times, 5 times, there's no limit on that, okay? It's all your time availability. Oh. Stay in the silence, stay in the state of samadhi.